Hey everyone, this is Travis, the Tao Templar. Let's talk about the essentials for a successful subnet and then explore some wild subnet ideas. Remember, we've got our three main participants: miners, validators, and stakers. Miners do the work, validators check and grant access to the work, and stakers check the value of the work. By using these participants, a subnet produces a valuable product or service. What are the requirements for creating a successful subnet? TAO, a variable amount of TAO, minimum of 100, is locked to gain ownership over a new subnet. You do get it back if your subnet is unsuccessful and gets deregistered. Open source. You have to be okay with your code being open source. You're creating an infrastructure that will allow miners to compete to produce the best product. Validator code is public. Base miner code is public, but it can be privately modified. Open access. Keep in mind that anyone can access the product or service via a validator. You are not creating proprietary data that only your organization has access to. Verifiable via code. The work must be checked via code, though you can do this through any programming language you want. The default is Python. Lastly, your product or service needs to be valuable to the network. Essentially, what this means is you need to have a product or service that actually has monetary value. Otherwise, you won't get emissions from stakers to reward your miners with. Let's go over some subnet examples increasing in wildness. The storage subnet. Miners store data, validators check and grant access to storing data. AI networks. Miners train models, validators confirm and grant access to the best models. Price prediction, subnet 8. Miners make trades, validators confirm that those trades were profitable, and then grant access to the most successful miners' trades. GPU hoard, subnet 12. Miners do difficult work where GPUs are required. Validators confirm that they have indeed provisioned the GPUs and grant access to the miners' collective compute power, thereby incentivizing miners to find the cheapest sources of powerful GPU. Human intelligence, subnet 36. Miners are humans, not computers, that provide responses that are valuable for training AI. There is a DEX on the testnet, 114, still under development. It is a unique idea for a DEX. Let's say a user wants to buy some Ethereum. Miners provide bids. That is the price they could fill the order at. The miner with the best price does a transaction with the user, facilitated by smart contracts and validators. Now let's explore some potential subnet ideas. We can follow a pattern of miners are workers and validators are managers. Delivery. Miners are drivers. Validators confirm that drivers have delivered packages by checking delivery times and sending surveys to users. A bounty subnet. Miners do tasks. Validators check the work. What about store management? Who checks if workers are working at a store? Managers. Can you verify that somebody is working at a store via code? Probably using video cameras or audio recordings, or something less intrusive like surveys sent to customers. They can be checked by code. Okay, now let's really go wild. What about subnets all the way down? What if you had a single miner be the product of an entire subnet? What if we had subnets within subnets? I, for one, am not only excited as an investor, but as a customer. Once validators start providing easy access, I want to use these services because I know they will consistently improve, powered by Bittensor's market incentive mechanisms. With all these subnets as examples, and knowing the number of subnets will scale up to over 1,000 in the next year, the scale of what lies ahead is unimaginable. Thank you.